Hello friends, in last video we discussed about the basics of laser. So in this video we discuss about the first type of laser, that is ruby laser. So the objective of this video is to understand and study the ruby laser, that is their construction and working of ruby laser. Now this slide shows the introductory part of the ruby laser. So it is solid state laser and was constructed by the scientist T.H. Maimon in 1960. Okay, now this ruby is the mixture of L2O3 and Cr2O3, in which 0.05% of L plus 3 ions are replaced by the Cr plus 3 ion. Okay, and the color of the rod is pink, and the active medium in the ruby rod is Cr plus 3 ions. Okay, now this slide shows the experimental setup of ruby laser. Okay, now one by one we discuss about the ruby laser. So first we'll discuss about the construction of ruby laser. Here if you see this figure, then it is observed that there is a ruby rod, okay, made up of ruby crystal, that is it is a mixture of L2O3 and Cr2O3. Okay, now this rod is taken in cylindrical form, having length is around 4 cm and 5 mm its a diameter. Okay, then its ends, now this is one end and this is other end, so its ends are grounded and polished such that the end faces are exactly parallel to each other and perpendicular to the axis of rod. Understood? These two ends of this rod are grounded and polished in such way that these two ends are perfectly parallel to each other but perpendicular to this axis of rod. Okay. Now one more thing here, this one face of this rod is silvered to achieve 100% reflection, while this opposite face or another face of this rod is partially silvered to make it semi-transparent. Okay, now the rod is surrounded by xenon discharge tube. Here we can see there is a xenon discharge tube which is surrounded around the ruby rod. Okay, and that xenon discharge tube, or we can say there is a flash lamp which is filled with the xenon. Okay, this xenon tube produces white light whenever activated by this power supply. Okay, now one more thing is there, the system or the whole system is cooled with the help of this coolant, and which is around the ruby rod. So this is the simple construction of ruby laser. Now we discuss about the working of ruby laser. Now for working purpose, here we can see the energy level diagram. Okay, now G indicates ground state level or lower energy level. Here M indicates metastable state, and H is nothing but the higher energy level, or we can say that excited state level. Okay, now what happen at the normal or thermal equilibrium condition or at the stable situation, most of the chromium atoms are in the ground state, that is in G state. Okay, Now when light coming from the flash tube, understood? Now the light which is coming from the flash tube and fall upon the ruby rod, then ground state chromium ion absorb that light having energy or having wavelength is around 5600 angstrom and excited to upper energy state, or we can say that excited to higher energy level H. Okay, now already I have told you atom in excited state does not stay for longer time. Its lifetime is very short, and due to this reason the excited atom try to come into the lower energy level. Okay, so these excited atom comes to this state, and this is nothing but the metastable state. Now the metastable state is the state where the atom stay for longer time compared to the excited state atom. Okay, and the metastable state atom has a lifetime is around 10⁻³ seconds, and due to this reason what happen, the number of atom in metastable state goes on increasing compared to number of atom present in a ground state. Okay, and due to this reason what happen, there is a population inversion achieved between these two states. Okay, now after that finally these chromium ions decay to the ground state and emitting light having wavelength is around 6943 angstrom. So this light emerges out from the partially silvered phase, and that emitted light acts as a laser beam. Understood? Now after that we'll discuss the demerits of ruby laser. So first demerit of ruby laser is the laser requires high pumping power. Second demerit of laser is the efficiency of this ruby laser is very small. Next one, it requires cooling. And last demerit of ruby laser is output of ruby laser is not continuous but occurs in the form of pulses of microsecond duration. Now these are some demerits of ruby laser. So like demerits there are some merits also. So merits of ruby laser are, first one, construction of this ruby laser is very simple. Second merit, operation is very easy. Third merit of ruby laser is very strong beam, as strong as 10,000 watt in power is produced. So these are some merits of ruby laser. So one more time we'll discuss about the construction and working of the ruby laser. So here for construction purpose, see this figure. So this is the experimental arrangement of the ruby laser. Okay, if you see this figure, then it is observed that here there is a ruby rod which is mixture of L2O3 and Cr2O3, okay, and which is in the form of cylindrical, having length is 4 cm and 5 mm it's a diameter. Understood? Now its ends are grounded. Here there is a one end and other end is here. Okay, so its ends are grounded and polished in such way that both the ends are parallel to each other but perpendicular to this axis of rod. Okay, now its one end is fully reflected, that is it is fully silvered to achieve 100% reflection, and other end is partially silvered to make it semi-transparent. Okay, now the rod is surrounded by helical photographic flash lamp and which is filled with the xenon. Okay, now this xenon discharge tube produced a white light whenever activated by this power supply, and the whole system is cooled with the help of this coolant, and which is around the ruby rod. So this is a simple construction of ruby laser. Now for working purpose, see this figure. This is the energy level diagram. Okay, here this G represent the ground state, M is nothing but the metastable state, and H indicates the higher energy state, or we can say that excited state. Okay, now at equilibrium condition, or we can say that at a stable situation, what happen? The most of the chromium ions are in ground state. Okay, so when the light coming from the flash tube which is fall upon the rod, then this ground state chromium atom absorb that light, having wavelength is around 5600 angstrom, and jump to the excited state, that is in H state. Okay, but again the excited atom in excited state does not stay for longer time. Its lifetime is around 10⁻⁷ seconds, and due to this reason this excited atom comes to the lower energy level, that is this excited atom comes to the metastable state, that is in M state. Okay, now metastable state is the state where the atom stay for longer time compared to the excited state atom. Okay, and the metastable state atom has a lifetime is around 10⁻³ seconds, and due to this reason the number of atom in metastable state goes on increasing compared to the number of atom present in a ground state. Okay, and hence the population inversion is achieved between the metastable state and ground state. Okay, now after that, finally this chromium ions decay to the ground state and emitting the light having wavelength is 6943 angstrom. So this light emerges out from the partially silvered face, and that partially silvered face emit light which acts as a laser beam. Understood? Now here these are demerits and merits of the laser. Thank you.